did you walk on by name? Hey, let me clean up here a little bit. Hang on, man. I'm trying to take care of business here, little listener. You know, dusting and cleaning and stuff like that. The life of a single guy. There you go. We got to do it all ourselves. That's right. Well, not everything, but, you know, we got to do it all ourselves. Right now, playing Simple Minds, Don't You Forget About Me. At least my bill collectors don't forget about me, that's for sure. They never forget about you, right? Beans and bill collectors coming on this. Let's go live. There we go, off of the movie soundtrack, The Breakfast Club, Simple Minds, Don't You Forget About Me. Simply love that movie, man, The Breakfast Club, right? Awesome movie. That movie's going to live forever and ever, amen. Good morning, Double R Radio, Wednesday morning, hump day Wednesday it is. Son las 8:50 de la mañana, el miércoles, el 22 de agosto, 2018. Hey, that rhymed, right? El 22 de agosto, 2018. Pretty good there. Not too bad, right? Pretty smooth. Anyways, people have asked me, Robert, have you always known Spanish? I actually took Spanish class. I took Spanish lessons in high school. Actually, junior high. I went to Kirby Junior High, and I almost got thrown out of Kirby Junior High, but that's another story. But I took Spanish in Kirby for a free credit. Not free, but you know how you got to build up credits, right, to move on? Well, I needed credits, man, and I said, you know what? I'm going to take Spanish. I'll take Spanish, man. Hey, man, I'll be good to go with Spanish. And, you know, I know Spanish. And I passed with a D minus. No lie, man. I passed with a D minus, pinche Spanish. But I learned a little bit of Spanish. I did. Good morning, Joel. I'm going to Olga Gracian. There we go. Olga Gracian. Good morning. I always forget to do this, man. There we go. I always forget to do that part. Anyways, I learned Spanish. Kind of weird. I started working for a record label, EMI Latin, and I started visiting a lot of these radio stations, and muchos eran mexicanos, españoles, nomás hablaban puro español. So, and they didn't care for me. They didn't want a Tejano. They wanted a Mexicano, so I said, I got to brush up on my Spanish or I'm not going to survive out here. So I didn't take no Spanish lessons. I just started listening to people talk, and I said, hey, this isn't so bad. I can pick up on this, right? And I started seeing novelas and Galavision and Univision and all these other kind of things, and you learn. You really, really do. Good morning, John. I'm going to Maria Lopez. Good morning, Maria. How we doing, Maria? Smile, Maria. Anyways, I mean, good morning, John. I'm going to Gural Garza. Did I say that right? Jural? It's probably going to be Jural Garza. I think I got that right. I think that G is silent there. So anyway, there you go. That's the way I knocked out my Spanish. There we have it. Hello, my friend. Olga says, hello, my friend Olga. How we doing? Anyways, I tell you what, it is time for question of the day. But I tell you what, before we go there and enough of the Spanish lessons, good morning, shout out to Rosemary Gomez. Good morning, Rosemary. Told your daughter, Mandy, I said, happy birthday. There we go. Olga says, y hablo español. Pues yo también, Olga, yo hablo español también, Olga. Ya sabes, Olga, vamos yo y tú una margarita, Olga, y ahí vamos a cenar, Olga, y un baile, Olga, y ahí vamos a ir a pasearnos ahí en el mar en Corpus Christi, Texas. My Spanish is not too bad here, man. I've got to brush up on my Spanish a little bit, but I think I'm going to be okay. Yeah, I think I'm going to be all right. The last time I tried using my Spanish, I went to a taquería, and I said, dame dos de blanquillo con huevo. And the girl goes, dije yo, dame dos de blanquillo con huevo. Y me dice, pues va a ser 50 centavos extra por combinación. And I said, 50 centavos extra por combinación. Y yo, no. Estoy pidiendo dos de blanquillo con huevo. And she goes, 50 centavos extra. And I go, all right, 50, whatever, man. Go ahead, whatever. Good morning, John. I'm going to Juanita Rosales. Good morning. Time for question of the day, but I tell you what, check this out, crazy story. A man was arrested along the highway. Why? Because he was standing there naked as a jaybird standing alongside the highway while cars were passing. How bored do you have to be to say, wake up in the morning and go, what am I going to do today? I know I'm going to take off my clothes and go to the highway and stand there naked. There you go. Well, anyways, a man was arrested for indecent exposure while standing on the side of the highway naked. a school bus passed by and a bunch of little elementary kids saw it, and they told the bus driver, "Sir, sir, sir, what's that we're seeing right there?" And the bus driver was quoted as saying, "Oh, that's a roly-poly." And there you go. And so now the kids think that it's a roly-poly. And there you have it. Anyways, it's the Juanita Rosales. Good morning. Rosemary Gomez says, "Will do, Robert. I'll tell my daughter, Mandy, you said happy birthday." Now, that being said, what else is going on here? Check this out. A 74-year-old woman was attacked by a person in the parking lot who tried taking away her purse and holding her while he was taking away his purse. The 74-year-old woman fought back by grabbing the man's, well, you know, down there, you know, she grabbed the man's, you know what those guys have down there. Well, she grabbed that guy's, you know, whatever he had down there, and held on to him until the cops were called and the cops showed up. The man is there, was arrested, and now they're saying that the man was going to live the rest of his life talking like Cyndi Lauper. There you go. So anyways, more power to the 74-year-old woman for fighting back and grabbing the man's, you know what. But that's the part that I don't like, because women know right away, man. If they're going to bring us guys down, they know what to do. I don't appreciate that whatsoever. Good morning, shout out to DJ Edward Castillo, who hasn't had a gig in 750 years, but he does not want to take off DJ in front of his name. Edward, enough is enough, Edward. Good morning, shout out to Cynthia Gonzalez Ramirez, Fred Romero. Buenos dias, buenos dias, buenos dias. Let's get to my question of the day. You know, I was thinking about this. I'm always on the road, and I see disagreements and arguments on the road and whatever. But let me tell you one thing I haven't seen in a long time, and I stay thinking about this. Good morning, shout out to my prima, Irene Gayona. Good morning, prima. I stay thinking about this, and I said, I wonder if it still lives or not. Because back in the day, I can remember when people, when they would get mad at somebody else or whatever, a stranger, whatever, right, you would throw them the finger. And you throw them the finger, right? You flip them off. I haven't seen somebody flip somebody off in a long, long, long time. Does this still exist? Do people still do this? Do people throw each other the finger? Or is it now like guns and bullets and chingazos and everything else? Have we gotten past this of flipping each other off? So, my question of the day, do people still flip each other off? Or is it a thing from the past? This is all true. When I was a little boy, I knew you were so young, so cute. You're probably going, what happened, Robert? Anyways, I was so young, so cute when I was a little boy. No lie, I grew up in the West Side. All true. I grew up in the West Side. And sometimes we'd have problems with our neighbors or whatever. I couldn't throw the finger the way I wanted to. I just didn't have it in me. So I had to get a stick and put it in my fingers so I could hold my fingers to go ahead and throw the finger the way I wanted to. No lie, man, I needed a stick to throw the finger at 4 years old. But I did it. I threw the finger at my neighbor. They deserved it. But really, think about this. When is the last time that you can remember you throwing the finger at somebody, flipping somebody off? Or turn it around. When is the last time you saw somebody flipping somebody off? I haven't seen that forever. That, you know, I'm old school, but that must be really old school for people to have quit doing it. Haven't seen it forever. Good morning, Joe. I got it to Angel Anna. Good morning, Joe Bypass Bravo. How you doing, Joe? Buenos dias, Maria Luna. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Head on over to Robert Reeves Internet Radio group page right now and answer me, pregunta por favor. Do people still flip each other off? Or is it a thing from the past? Good morning, shout out to Richard and Lisa. Buenos dias, buenos dias. It is Wednesday morning, hump day, Wednesday it is. Let's keep it going. Let's do some Brooks and Dunn. A little neon moon on this Wednesday morning. I'm going to play the song and I'm going to take a nap. Good morning. There we go. Brooks and Dunn, neon moon. Good morning, everybody. Anyways, it's the, you know, I just got back from vacation, man, and I'm serious, man. I'm still trying to recover from my vacation. I'm beat up and tired and lazy and everything. I think I need another vacation. I need a vacation to recover from my vacation. Really, man. I still can't, you know, get back into the groove, man. For right now, I can't. Anyways, let's get back to the morning show. Join me, RobertRivasRadio.com. It's that simple. RobertRivasRadio.com. Click on the blue button that says mobile app. It's all free. Join me.